It is nature's surround sound. And it is created by the whooping of the tundra swans, the quacking of ducks, the squawking of coots, the honking of Canada geese, and the sounds of dozens of other migrating waterfowl that spend the winter at the Pocosin Lakes National Wildlife Refuge. The winged chorus of bird calls echoes across the lake and the landscape. It is deafening, amazing, and inescapable, even for the turtle, which appears to be heading back to the water to get away from it all.
Never get tired of it.
Why?
Never get tired of it. It's just different than what you see in most places, and it's beautiful, and it's a part of the creation that we're supposed to be taking care of, and so that's what we're doing.
Pocosin Lakes National Wildlife Refuge near Columbia lies in the middle of the Atlantic Flyway. The flyway is a migration path that generally follows the Atlantic coast of the United States and the Appalachian Mountains. The endpoints are the Canadian Maritime Provinces to the north and the Gulf of Mexico in the south. It is one of four waterfowl flyways that stretch across the country.
Okay, so I got swans, and then I have ducks right next to it, and then there's...
Beyond that,
okay.
Yes, if you can focus on the area beyond
the... The central location of the refuge means that between October and February, about 100,000 migrating waterfowl will winter at the refuge. There are more than a dozen species.
There's also some Canada geese out there that I saw. They're straight off there at the point. There's quite a few coots swimming around. There are probably a couple thousand of green-winged teal, which are some of the smallest ducks. I saw some gadwall earlier, and some black ducks, and some I think there were some northern pintail earlier, too.
Biologist Elaine Barr performs ground surveys and aerial surveys to count the birds.
It's very visual, so you kind of train your eye to see. As you said, so you train your eye to see, okay, that's 10 birds, that's 50 birds, that's 100 birds, that's 500 birds, 1,000, 5,000. So it's really about training your eye to see those groups and see those patterns.
It takes a lot of training and practice to visualize the clumpings or groupings of birds, which allows you to count the flocks quickly. It's even more of a challenge when you see this, a thin white line that looks like a dusting of snow on the opposite shore of Pungo Lake.
Well, you're close when you say snow because it's a thick line of snow geese, and they tend to group closely together like that. And that's how you can tell them apart from a grouping of tundra swans, which is obviously another type of white bird we have here at Pocosin. So they'll spend their time between here, resting on the lake, and then going out to the fields.
Look away for a moment, and suddenly the dusting of snow becomes a cloud, a blur of motion that rises and swells and changes color from white to gray and back again.
And this year we've been getting numbers between 30 and 40,000 snow geese on the lake at a time, and I would say that's probably about what we have out there right now.
The surveys of birds provide scientists with a means to monitor the health of huge populations, not only at the present time, but over time.
And then we also get that long-term data. So we have data back from the 60s, as Howard was mentioning. So you see that trends over time, which is really important. And also, all of our data here at the refuge gets uploaded to a national, and I guess if you count Canada, international level. And so that goes with duck numbers, they get uploaded to the Atlantic Flyway and things like that. And that helps with national and international conservation efforts. So you'll know if, you know, for example, we might have good numbers of black ducks here, but other states might not have good numbers, and then we'll know that we need to start focusing conservation efforts on that.
The refuge is scientifically managed to provide the best habitat for migrating waterfowl. The birds spend their time on the water and in the neighboring fields, resting from the journey south, feasting on leftover grain, and fattening up for their return to the north.
There's the lake, Pungo Lake, which is 2,800 acres. And it is used primarily by the waterfowl as a roosting and loafing area. It's a historic site for the birds. They've come here for eons, and it's the primary draw probably for the area. The other two prongs are our cooperative farming program and the farming area that we have, and the moist soil management areas, the moist soil impoundments that we have. The cooperative farming program, we bring in local farmers, and they farm the ground for us, but rather than paying us rent for using that land, we have them leave a portion of the crop in the field for wildlife, and in particular for the waterfowl. The moist soil units, on the other hand, we can manipulate the water levels and produce high quality waterfowl foods, native or natural plants.
Researchers say while their counts of specific bird species may rise and fall somewhat from year to year, the overall counts of migrating waterfowl are holding steady. Refuge managers say the bird counts are good news as development continues to threaten wetlands, and a sign the work of the refuge is succeeding.
You have to find new and improved ways of managing for them, but I think actually we're probably seeing conditions improve, or the amount of habitat improve, with the conservation efforts that are going on nationwide. It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. No other way to describe it.